All right! Welcome to Rockstar! Now, just so you all know, we're going to cover this topic as fast and as completely as we can. Just the way you like it. Thanks for watching!
Chapter 1, Bullying Amplified. Imagine waking up at 6:30 a.m. to a loud ringing in your ear. You immediately jump up and start scrambling around to stop the irritating sound of your cell phone. In the midst of trying to figure out if you've overslept, you notice that it's still dark outside. Your mind clears as you find your phone and the screen lights up. One incoming text message. While thinking to yourself, I really need a new ringtone, you click on the message icon and notice it's from an unknown number. It reads, check this out, and includes a link to an unknown website. As you make your way to your computer, you can't help wondering who the mystery number belongs to. You log on and 15 unread instant messages pop up, all from an unidentified user. You click on the first message, which reads, die. Then you open the second message, which reads, today you and your family are going to die. Your heart sinks as you realize that the rest of the messages will probably be worse, and you have no idea who sent them. You decide to skip the rest of the messages and check out the link. The first thing that pops up on the website is a picture of you with a noose drawn around your neck. After that, you see pictures of your parents' faces pasted onto pictures of dead bodies. The knot in your stomach goes from tightness to nausea within seconds. You have just been the victim of an attack, but you don't have any clue who your tormentor is. You don't know how serious the threat could be because you have no idea who sent them. What do you do? Bullying is a very important issue today among kids and teens. Bullying, otherwise known as affecting victims by using force or intimidation, has always been around, but the internet has amplified the effects of bullying. While technology offers plenty of advantages, it also provides a negative space where bullies can constantly harass their victims at all hours of the day. Bullying is taken much more seriously than it used to be. Media coverage surrounding the Columbine High School shooting of 1999 pointed to bullying as the catalyst for these unfortunate and catastrophic crimes. This massacre and other school shootings were a major turning point for how parents, teachers, and authorities saw bullying and the way they handled it. Cyberbullying is a newer term that was coined in 2004. The simple definition, according to cyberbullying.org, is, quote, when somebody repeatedly harasses, mistreats, or makes fun of another person online or while using cell phones or other electronic devices. Because of the constant change in technology, there are many different ways cyberbullying can take place. Some cyberbullying tactics include denigration, which is using cruel gossip or rumors to damage someone's reputation or friendship. Harassment, which is repeatedly sending insulting, offensive, or rude messages. Cyberstalking is repeatedly sending threatening messages to intimidate and threaten a victim. This would include online activities that make the victims feel unsafe. Impersonation is when somebody pretends to be the victim by sending or posting material that will make the victim look bad, damage their reputation, or get them in trouble. Flaming is the use of vulgar or angry language to start fights with the victim using electronics. Text messages are also a tool of bullying. The bully gets friends together to send many messages to the victim's cell phone, possibly running up the victim's phone bill and getting them into trouble with their parents. Password theft is when a bully gains access to the victim's password and uses it to lock them out of their accounts or to allow others to hack into their accounts. Websites can also be created and filled with material to target a cyberbullying victim. PC attacks are another tool that cyberbullies can use. They can send viruses, worms, trojans, and spyware to attack and damage the victim's computer. Finally, cyberbullies can use images. The cyberbully posts photos of the victim that are embarrassing. Sometimes these images are enhanced or altered using sophisticated graphic software programs. For most parents and teachers, the term cyberbullying is new, but it's a term that kids and teens today are raised with. Today's parents are from a generation that didn't always have computers in their homes, and telephones were something that remained only in the home. They weren't individually owned and carried around in each person's pocket. So it can be difficult for adults to grasp the seriousness of the effects of cyberbullying. Many parents and adults view the issue as part of growing up or making kids stronger. But cyberbullying has changed the impact that bullying had 15 or even just 10 years ago. With social media, text messaging, and instant messaging, today's teens can be taunted 24/7 instead of getting a break when the school bell rings at the end of the day. Cyberbullying is basically bullying on steroids. Cyberbullying is a growing epidemic that deserves the full attention of teens, parents, and teachers so that it can be prevented. Endless teasing and harassment is a major problem at schools, as well as at home on the internet. It's also, very sadly, the cause for the rise of suicidal thoughts among teens and young adults. 1 million teens on Facebook experience being harassed or threatened. 1 in 6 junior high kids have been the victims of cyberbullying. Of those millions of kids, 8% have experienced suicidal thoughts. The number of victims from bullying and cyberbullying continues to increase each year and seriously affects the victims involved. Victims can experience short-term or long-term effects, anything from depression, anxiety, post-traumatic stress disorder, physical and emotional illness, and even suicide. Although there are often many contributing factors as to why an individual commits suicide, 15 to 25 cases reported each year are due to bullying. Media coverage has paid special attention to these cases in recent years and applies the term bullycide. There are usually different people involved anytime bullying occurs, and they all have different levels of participation in the situation. A person's role in bullying depends on what a person does or how they feel as bullying takes place. First, there's the kid who starts the bullying, and the followers who will also take part in the bullying, but who didn't start it. There are the supporters who will laugh or do something else to show that they approve of it, but aren't actually directly bullying the victim. There are also passive supporters. These are people who watch and might enjoy it, but don't cheer or support it outwardly. Then you have your general onlookers, who watch but don't get involved in any way and are basically neutral. There are also possible defenders who want to help the victim, but don't. A recent study showed that a large majority of students felt bad for those who were bullied, but rarely did anything to stop it. Witnesses of bullying often remain silent because they're afraid of becoming the next target. There are also defenders who actively try to help whoever's being bullied and stand up for them. And then, at the center of the situation, you have the victim themselves. Most of the time, victims will remain silent rather than standing up for themselves or turning to a friend or an adult for help. Out of everyone who's bullied, only 11% confide in an adult. If you are feeling threatened, endangered, or emotionally hopeless, it's very important to go to a person of authority and to remember not to blame yourself. If you're being bullied, it's not your problem, it's the bully's problem. There have always been mean kids out there in the world, but with the internet in the situation, it can become downright unbearable, and you don't have to accept cyberbullying in silence. It's better to get help than to give in to intolerance. Legislature is beginning to pass laws criminalizing the acts of bullying and cyberbullying. 48 of the 50 states in the U.S. have laws prohibiting bullying. 38 states have laws against electronic harassment, and 11 states have a criminal sanction against violators. For most of these states, this means that bullies can be arrested and face Class B misdemeanors. The penalty for Class B misdemeanors may include fines of up to $1,000 or imprisonment for up to 90 days or both. Repeat offenders could face up to 2 years in prison. As the issues continue to grow, state laws defending victims of harassment are being proposed and passed daily. Along with a huge change in laws, many schools are adopting a zero-tolerance policy, which results in the immediate suspension or expulsion of students who bully. A combination of these consequences will make it difficult for those who bully to get into colleges and to find jobs. Hopefully, these consequences will give bullies a reason to think twice about hurting others, either physically or with words. The most important and vital advice one can give to victims of harassment is the guarantee that they are not alone and it does indeed get better. So it's crucial for you to understand that no matter what your interest, quirkiness, or eccentricity is, there's a place in society where you'll excel and succeed. One great example of this is Steve Jobs, creator of Apple. Many people don't know that he was tormented and bullied daily as a kid. But in his biography, Jobs admits to being the victim of harassment on a frequent basis. Jobs told his parents that if he couldn't change schools, then he would drop out of junior high. No one ever wonders what happened to his bullies, but just about everyone knows Steve Jobs and his legacy. While junior high or high school seems like the most important factor of your life right now, trust me, there's a world much greater beyond it. And in that world, there's room for individuality and opportunity for everyone to be themselves.
Well, all right. We hope you enjoyed that. You just did it, the first chapter of the topic. Now, just so you know, there are four more chapters to go in this app, and it will only take you about 45 more minutes to complete, and you are totally done. Now check this out. The app also comes with about 15 pages of analysis and summary that you can download and use any way you need to. Here's what you got to do. You got to click the link below and go directly to the Apple App Store and download the full app. It's fast and easy to do.